So what are the best drones for content creators in 2019? I'm here with Aldrin from The Flight Path, drone expert and YouTuber, and he's gonna be breaking down the best drones this year, whether you're beginner, intermediate, or advanced, and for every budget. Coming up. This video is brought to you by Skillshare. A lot goes into building a successful YouTube channel, learning video editing, photography, graphic design, and smart business skills. Skillshare gives you access to over 25,000 online classes so you can develop the skills you need to succeed and crush your goals this year. I love getting access to classes from social media experts like Guy Kawasaki and YouTubers like Thomas Frank's class on productivity or Sarah Deechi's class on how to vlog. Skillshare is also super affordable with annual subscriptions coming in at less than $10 a month. Join more than 7 million creators learning with Skillshare, and the first 500 Think Media subscribers to use the link in the description will get a 2-month free trial. Just click the link in the description to get started today. Hey, what's up guys? Sean here with Think Media, bringing you the best tips and tools for building your influence with online video. And I'm here with Aldrin from The Flight Path. How's it going?
Good, good, good. How you doing, Sean?
Super pumped to have you on our channel. And I love it that you're here because we definitely do some drone flying, but you're the master, you're the expert. And of course, everyone's wondering, 2019, what drones are the best deals right now, the best bang for your buck, depending on where you're starting. And so let's go for a couple different levels, starting off maybe for beginners.
I still recommend, even though it's probably what, over 2 years old now, is the Mavic Pro Platinum. Now, it's an older drone, even for beginners, I would say, or anyone starting to get into it, because I think the biggest thing that's, when you're starting to use drones, the one thing that's always kind of scary is transmission and understanding that. So like the Spark and the Mavic Air are absolutely phenomenal drones, but I would like to keep those more closer proximity type of drones, where the Mavic Pro has, you know, OcuSync, which you're able to go a few miles out. And I never really go that far out, but at the same time, to know it can do that, is what you want to feel comfortable doing.
And to break that down, it's really because the Air and the Spark are almost like Wi-Fi kind of transmission, where when you move into the more professional, you're doing radio frequencies, right? And that's huge, because if you've ever had a drone get out of range, or when it starts, you lose your picture, it starts getting sketchy, you're like, man, I'm going to lose control. So that's a great recommendation.
Yeah, and that's exactly what it is. I think the one thing that you want to make sure that you're doing is just being comfortable. It's very easy to be overconfident when you get these drones, because you put them up in the air, it's GPS locked. It feels like, oh my God, it's so easy. I can just throw it out there super far. But if you are Wi-Fi based, like you said, it's transmission's a little bit shorter. And anytime you have, you know, a weak transmission or your screen goes black, I mean, it's definitely a freak out moment. And if you have something, I would say like something at the bare minimum, like the Mavic Pro, a Mavic Pro Platinum, all the way up to the newer ones now have the, you know, the more recent OcuSync technology. That's hardly going to happen. So comfortability-wise, even especially if you're new, you want to be able to feel reliable throwing it out there, you know, half mile, a mile away, knowing you'll have a good reception.
And so depending on your budget, if you're on the low end and you only have maybe, you got $500 to spend, to $500 to $700, what are you going to spend that on?
If I had $500 to $700, and you're still going new, I think you could still get like the Mavic Air. It's definitely a good travel drone, as well as the Platinum. Platinum probably say around the $700 to $800 ones now, because it is a couple years old. But if you had to spend maybe $500, a Mavic Air might work for you, just because it's really compact and it has a little bit better of a Wi-Fi transmission than it does than the Spark does. But I mean, if you're keeping it close proximity, it'd be a great drone. It's just a little bit more louder as far as like the whiny motor spin up than the Platinum. And that's the reason why I like the Platinum too, is because it's a little bit, it has the lowest noise level wise.
And so then if I've got $1,000 to spend, what are you gonna do?
$1,000, I'd definitely say, at the bare minimum, Mavic Pro, Platinum, and then batteries.
Like a flight kit or just...
Yeah, definitely get the flight kit. You're always going to want to have an extra, you know, two to three batteries when you're out there.
I love that. And then if you've got $1,500, you're going to go for the Mavic 2.
Yep, absolutely. Mavic 2. The zoom is a really good one if you want to get a little bit more kind of creative. It has the zoom options on it, so you can kind of get some more creative shots. But I'm more on the Mavic Pro side because I love to do photography. So for me, I want to be able to have a little bit higher resolution on my photos.
And then finally, what are your tips for maybe taking advantage of the fact that people always want the newest drones, maybe picking up like an older drone? Have you ever thought about secondhand? Any advice there?
Oh, for sure. I think the thing is, it's, you know, drones are definitely one of those things where people get so excited about and they want the latest one. But then you kind of realize maybe you're not using it as much as it's just like, like a camera. It's like, ooh, latest DSLR, latest, I want it. And then you realize like I'm not using all the functions. I really didn't need it. So I would definitely say pick up, a quality secondhand or, get one of the more affordable ones to see if it's something that you're going to be actually using in your toolkit. Because a lot of people will buy it. And next you see them, you use it for a couple shots and then it's stored away. And next three, four, five more drones come out. Start with something to see if you're going to start using it more and more. And if you do, then I would say just like a camera system, you're just going to start leveling it up because of the fact that you realize you need it.
Yeah, I love that. For us, I upgraded to a Phantom Advanced from Craigslist, and I just found a guy. They bought two, and they weren't using it, like the second one, so I got a super good deal on it. The downside, of course, of the Phantoms is they're so massive. I never travel with it on a plane. I only, if I'm on the road, will I throw it in the trunk of my car. But super great deal, amazing drone as well.
Yeah, I love my Phantoms. I'm not sure if DJI is going to come out with anything new as far as some of the newer Phantoms. But yeah, I still have the Phantom 4 Pro Plus with a built-in screen. Now that the DJI just came out with the smart controller, makes it just a seamless process. You literally just power on the remote, power on the drone, and then you're up and flying. There's no fumbling around with cords and mounts and things like that. So to be more efficient, I think some of the new stuff that they have is amazing.
I agree. And I would say that my personal dream setup this year, what we're hoping to upgrade, would be the Mavic 2 Pro with the remote. Get some filters for that, man. You're good to just crush.
That's all you need for a while. I don't know if even it gets bigger sensor. I don't know what else you're gonna really need for it.
That'd be killer, but that's like $2,300-$2,400. So we covered a lot of different drones. We're gonna put a whole big summary in the YouTube description below if you want to see some show notes, some specific drone models with details to help you out. So that's all down there. Aldrin, how can people connect with you? Great YouTube channel. Go over there, subscribe for everything drones, but what are the details?
Yeah, I'm on YouTube. I'm on youtube.com/flightpath, FLYTPATH. And then I'm also really active on Instagram at Aldrin, ALDRYN. And then on Twitter, I actually have the handle at ACE. So at ACE is my Twitter handle. So hit me up on there.
Now, besides drones, there's a lot of cool new tech for creators like you that's been coming out. And that's why we're here at CES dropping a bunch of new videos. So if you want to see the entire playlist, we'll link that up on the YouTube card and post it in the description below. Question of the day, are you thinking about upgrading to a different drone this year or getting a drone for the first time? Which one are you looking at? Let me know in the comments section below.